Contact with machinery can cause serious and life-altering injuries. While there are many different solutions to a given issue, keep these four simple things in mind when assessing your safeguarding. 1. Consider all hazards associated with a given machine. For example, many people would agree that using a table saw could result in a serious cut or amputation. But there are other associated hazards, like splinters from handling the wood, hearing loss due to noise, slipping on sawdust, kickback if the material catches the blade, and airborne dust getting in the eyes. If you're looking for mechanical hazards, think MAC, M-A-C. Is there motion? Is there access? And is there a consequence? If you have all three, you need safeguarding to protect your workers. Contact with electrical components, chemical exposures, and ergonomic factors can be additional considerations for machine safety. 2. Use risk to guide your safeguarding decisions. Once you have identified hazards, you need to estimate the risk associated with those hazards. Each hazard will play a role in different tasks. For example, a machine operator will face different scenarios than a setup or maintenance staff. Once the task and hazard combinations are determined, a risk estimation can help you select risk reduction measures, which can include safeguarding. 3. Ensure the safeguarding is effective. In some cases, safeguarding disappears or is bypassed. This could be attributed to poor design or lack of consideration for how a given task is performed. A properly selected safeguard will allow a task to be completed safely. Before your barrier, light curtain, or area scanner is in place, see if it would pass the auto test. Could someone reach around, under, through, or over and still access a hazard? Note that this determines if someone could access the hazard without asking why somebody would do this. The auto test is also useful for reviewing existing safeguarding measures. And 4, utilize consensus standards to design your solution. Canadian Standards Association has several standards to help guide safeguarding with power presses, robots, and general safeguarding. ANSI and ISO also have equipment-specific standards that can provide guidance as you design and implement your machine safety initiatives. By following these 4 simple steps, you're on your way to creating a safer work environment. I'm Mike Wilson, and this has been your health and safety tip from Workplace Safety and Prevention Services. For more information, visit WSPS.ca.